Well, my name is Wendy Cabrera. This is my daughter, Iliana Rose. I just had her July 22nd. And I'm at St. Gerard because of my mother. She works at the bank. And it just so happened that Teresa walked in. And I was thinking about having an abortion. And so Teresa talked to my mom, told her to give me, you know, give her number so I could call. And it was really hard for me because, you know, the baby's father had just, you know, we had our difficulties and, you know, and he wanted me to get rid of her. I didn't want to. And something deep down told me not to. And so I called Teresa. I told her my problem, you know. And she helped me, you know. She helped me get my apartment, you know. She helped me get what my things done. Or she gave me a boost. And I went. And it inspired me to go and get my stuff done. And, you know, her father, he's in love with her now. You know, and it was hard for me though. You know, I was, because of my pregnancy, I was fired from my job. And it was hard for me. I was having problems. But, you know, now that I see her, now that I, you know, have her in my arms and all that, it's, it was actually worth it. Because she pushes me and she inspires me to want to do better, want to be better, you know, to actually accomplish my goals for her. And so, you know, yeah, abortion is, you know, the easiest way out, you know. But once you have them, it's like, wow, you know. It is, even now, you know, I still can't believe, you know, I have a daughter. It was the last thing I, you know, imagined I would have. Especially now, because I'm 20, you know. I always figured I would go to school and, you know, go to college and all that, you know, never figured I would be a mom. And, because I used to babysit all my nephews, nieces. So I'm like, oh, I don't want no kids anytime soon, but, you know, things happen. And, I'm just really glad that I kept her. You know, I wouldn't, if I had to do everything all over again, I'd probably do it a little better, but I would do it probably the same. If that makes sense. You know, I make better decisions, but if it all came, you know, back to end up having her again, I would do it all over, you know. And yeah, the labor is, you know, they tell you different stories about it, and you know how it hurts, and how, you know, I even was watching movies where women die during labor. But you know, like I said, it's worth it in the end, you know, because you see them, they look up at you and they smile, because that's what she did. She was wide awake, and, you know, when she was born, and she was laughing and everything. And it just, I love waking up and, you know, having her look at me, you know, because as you see, look how cute she is. You know, and she's my world right now. You know, she is. And my mom, who was one of the main people who wanted me to have an abortion, is, you know, yeah, it was hard because I wanted her to, you know, to be supportive, and instead all she kept doing was telling me to get rid of her for nothing, because now this is her princess. It's grandma's little girl. And she calls me every day, 2-3 times a day, and if she's not calling me, she's texting me, asking how the baby's doing, how her little princess is doing. You know, but when I needed people, I didn't care what people thought, you know, because everybody told me to get rid of it, you know, that I could start over, you know, that it was easier for me. It was mostly because of the guy who, you know, her father, who he was. But, you know, like I said, things happen, you know. You just, if you believe that you can do it, you know, just do it. You know, because if it was up to everybody else, she would not be here right now. You know, I didn't care what anybody else's opinion. I said, you know what? I want her. I don't care. I don't care if anybody else doesn't. She has all the love from me, you know, and I'm trying to go back to school now, you know, I'm trying to get a job. You know, my mom even volunteered to babysit her, because like I said, this is grandma's little girl. And my mom even told me, you know, she wasn't going to be there when I was going to have the baby, if the father was there, and they were both with me. The two people who told me to get rid of her, they were with me, you know, they were there at my side. Had her father on one side and my mother on both crying while I'm screaming. But you know, it is funny how the people that, you know, who instead of supporting you and all that, you know, the people that you want and you need them to support you, they're the ones that put you down the most. But yeah, when it comes to it, you know, they're the ones that are mostly there afterwards, you know, because her father's in love with her now. It's daddy's little girl, you know, and he almost hit the nurses because they made her cry. You know, and my mom, she like I said, she calls me 10 times a day, and if she's not calling me, she's texting me another 20 times a day. Sometimes I'll try to answer her back and she'll be calling me at the same time. You know, and she'll come and she'll take her for a few hours. She'll go and spend time with her, you know. And now she goes to the store. We have to go buy the baby aisle, you know. And she wants to buy her everything, you know. And she's a lot more supportive now, you know. Because she figured, you know, she's a grandma. The baby's here already, you know. There's nothing she can do about it. And she adores him, you know. And it is just, like I said, in the beginning, yeah, it's hard, you know, but afterwards, in reality, it's all worth it. And I actually did that ultrasound in the St. Gerard. And it's funny because everybody was trying to get her face. But nobody, she didn't want to show her face to anybody. But the St. Gerard caught her. And they actually had pictures a lot better than the Hartford Hospital. See, this is her face. The first glance of her face. I was actually impressed. I'm like, wow, you guys actually caught her. You know, and this is, she's on her stomach. While they were doing the ultrasound, she thought she was swimming. And she was moving her arms, which I have a picture of her arm as well. Where she thought she was swimming. And so she was moving her arms and all that. And this is the last one. They actually had, you know, a lot better ultrasound than the Hartford Hospital. Even, I was actually impressed with them. And it just, you know, I'm grateful for Teresa, you know, and the St. Gerard, because honestly, without them, she wouldn't be here, and you know, there would be a lot of things that I wouldn't have been able to do without them. And you know, if you think you could, you know, if you think you can do it, just don't give up, because an abortion, that's something you live with for the rest of your life, and you can't take it back. And so I just, you know, just looking at this every day, I'm glad I didn't get one.